Good to meet you, man. It's good to meet you. So you're CCNA and you're CCNP.
Yes, sir. And I recently received the Juniper Associate Certification as well.
Oh, wow. That's awesome. So you're going across the board. You're learning all this stuff. Are you going to get into Python and all this now automation, SD-WAN, Nexus, all these different things that's going on?
Yes. Well, currently my position is in the data center. I'm a data center engineer.
Okay.
And I'm dealing with Ansible and Python.
Okay.
To automate network, you know, SDN programmability.
Okay.
So what I do is I create Python modules if there's not already one, because Ansible has a very vast collection of Cisco, Juniper, Brocade, F5, a whole bunch of stuff right there. So you don't have to reinvent the wheel. You don't have to really know a whole bunch of Python to get into it.
Okay.
But in case you do, you can create your own Python module. Let's say you want to do a software upgrade on a Cisco, and there's not already a module for that. Well, you can create your own.
Okay.
And Ansible will push it to as many devices as you want. And it'll give you confirmation whether it worked, didn't work. Why didn't it work? Stuff like that. And my job primarily focuses on creating what Ansible calls playbooks.
Now, what is it? What is it again? It's called what?
Playbooks.
Oh, playbooks. Okay.
Yes. So these playbooks, how they work is basically you have the name of the playbook, right? Let's say you want to update the OS.
Okay.
Then with the playbook, you specify hosts. How many hosts do you want to push this out to? Then after that, you have the things called tasks. And then within the tasks, you can specify, for example, information gathering from the host. You can pull information and say, wait a minute, this host is already on the latest firmware, don't push it to him. But this other one isn't, so push it to that guy.
So
then you can build in logic within the playbook itself.
So this is going to be a little bit more mainstream. You know, you don't have to go all over the place to be rolling out different things. It's going to be a lot easier for IT personnel to do what they need to do. Somewhere like the SD-WAN type of thing, where instead of rolling out to, like, you know, 1,000 different computers, and it takes, you know, maybe 5,000 commands that you have to write because of 5,000, you know, all these computers. It's just one thing, and then you decide who you're going to roll it out to. And also, it's just streamlining everything, making everything a lot more automated, a lot more easier.
Super simple. You take out the human error, because you might mistype something.
Oh, of course.
In the CLI.
Oh, of course.
And it just makes your job a whole lot easier. And plus, everybody is going toward Ansible and automation. I know there's also things like Chef and Puppet and Salt. I've tried all those.
Okay.
So far, Ansible seems to be what the industry is going toward.
Dude, let me ask you. So I don't mean to interrupt you. You say you're 22 years old, right?
Yes.
You're pretty young to know all this stuff, I think. I mean, I started learning this stuff when I was 32. I'm 52 now, okay? You're 22 years old. Thank you, sir. I appreciate that. But you are, I mean, you're 22 years old. When did you actually start getting into IT? One. Two, how in the world did you find me? I mean, I got a big bald head and a big mouth, and I guess that's how you found me. I don't know, but you tell me. But how did you get into this, the IT thing? Did you always like it, or somebody push you towards it? What is it?
Well, here's the thing. I guess to explain, to tell you that, I would have to go back to the very beginning.
Okay, go ahead.
So, I come from Cuba. I came here when I was 9 years old.
Six.
Right. So you understand that there's no internet for me. I was living in a little pueblo. It was super small. I didn't know what the internet was. Almost nobody had a computer. I had never seen a computer. Right.
Okay.
So we get here, and of course it's very dramatic change.
Yes.
The whole economy. Figuring out what to do for parents, you know, a whole different language, culture. It was crazy. But when I started going to school, I started playing around with computers. I started seeing that a lot of stuff had to be done online for my parents and stuff. So I had to catch up pretty quickly to the modern age.
Yeah, yeah.
Catch up with the family. Every time somebody has a problem, they come to me. They're like, "Hey, why isn't this working?" 80% of the time, you turn it off, turn it back on again, it works, right?
Exactly. But you're the IT guy, so they're all gonna come to you.
For a vast majority of stuff. So I started liking working with technology, working with computers, fixing them, opening them up, seeing what was going inside. Even back then, I didn't really know what CPU, GPU, RAM, I didn't know what that was, but I was like looking in there, I'm like, what does that do? What does this do? So I started college. I know I wanted to go to college.
Okay.
And back then I didn't really know about certifications.
Okay.
You know, my parents would just say, "Hey, you know, going to college, it's always going to help you out."
Of course.
And I've seen
ammunition.
And I've seen how my parents and my family members were at these, and they still are at these really physically hard jobs.
Yeah.
And I started thinking, I don't want to be doing that for the rest of my life. And I also want to help out my family and provide for them, just as, you know, they came over here. Now let me help you. So I went to, I started here in a community college called CNM, Central New Mexico.
Okay.
Community college. And I started as a web developer.
Okay. Wow, that's interesting.
Because, yes, a lot of people, especially a lot of young people, you know, you ask them, "Hey, what do you want to do?" And they're like, "I don't really know." Right? And that was me. I didn't really know what, I knew I liked technology, but I didn't know exactly what I wanted to go into.
Okay.
And for those that really don't know what to do, I say just at least go try out something. You know, it could be whatever. Maybe if it's technology, try something technology. And then within that path, you might say, "Hey, I don't really like this, but I do like that other thing. So let me go over there."
Okay.
And that's how it was for me. Because I started as a web developer.
And how old were you? How old were you already when you say, okay?
Straight out of high school, I was 18.
18 years old. Okay, so in 18, so in 4 years, you went from being a web developer or studying to be a web developer,
yes,
now working at a data center, knowing all these different programs, all this different architecture, all these different things.
Yes.
That's amazing. And to get, in these 4 years, to get your Cisco certifications as well, because CCNP is three certs, as you well know. And that's an accomplishment in itself. And a lot of people, I didn't mean to cut you off, but a lot of people don't understand that. You have the right reasons. You know, you said, "You know what? I'm not just doing this for myself. I'm doing it for my family. I saw how they struggled when they came over to this country," because I saw my parents struggle when they came over to this country. I didn't have the smarts that you did, though. I did other things, worked warehousing, fast food restaurants, retail stores, all this stuff. It took me to get to the age of 32 and meet my wife, slap me in the back of the head and tell me, "Go to college, study something." Yeah. Luckily, I had people that told me about certifications. So I did, as I was going through the college, I was taking my certification. So, but in 4 years, you've accomplished so much. How did you make the time to do that? I mean, how did you do it? I mean, it takes a lot. I mean, studying, getting certified, working, all these things.
It was a lot, to be honest with you. When I switched over from being a web developer to network administration, is what the degree name was. It was quite a big jump.
Yeah.
Because I didn't know the networking world was so vast. I mean, you have security, you have data center, you have cloud, you have so many things. And I was like, wow, like there's a lot of growth here. Like,
yes.
You can go into this and make it a career. Because the thing I switched over was because the web developer, I was already getting the hang of, building a website. I'm like, I don't know if this is going to told much in 10, 15 years, right?
Okay.
So I went over to the other program. I loved it. I didn't know where the switch was. I didn't know what a router was. I didn't know anything.
That's awesome.
But my professor, Robert Hennigan, he's now retired. He's the one that pointed me to your videos because I was having trouble with subnetting and OSPF. And he's like, hey, you know what? You should see this guy on YouTube called The Networking Doctors. I was like, okay. And as soon as I saw you, the way that you teach, the way that you come across your ideas to people, I was like, it's pretty awesome.
Thank you, bro. I appreciate that.
I've been watching you since...
Not too long. You can't have been watching me too long. I mean, 4 years, you got all the way up to here. I mean, I appreciate it. I'm glad that you found me. And he pointed you to me, which is interesting. But, you know, it's always good to hear because we're both Cuban. It's to see somebody that came from another country over here and made it. And you made it because I just put out a YouTube video right now. I don't know if you saw it or not. I think you did. It was based on college and certifications. And there's a lot of people out there that can take what you're saying, you know, and take your path and say, you know what? I need to do this not only for myself. I need to do it for my family. I need to take responsibility. I need to do this. I need to improve my life because just what I do now, because I've worked in telecommunications. I've worked in IT departments. I've worked in a place called The Answer Group, which is a huge help desk in Fort Lauderdale, which was a nightmare. I didn't find my niche until, and I never in my life thought that I would be teaching. But I get fulfillment talking to guys like yourself that I was able to help and that, but I only give you a spark. I only give you certain information. I may motivate you, but you did the hard work. Because let me tell you, brother, at the age of from 18 to 22, hello, from 18 to 22, I was not even thinking about anything but going out, you know, doing hard labor jobs, not even thinking about anything until, because even my own father, he does TV production. He gave me opportunities. I didn't take it. You know what I mean? But it took a little bit, you know, of more maturity. You can see that you're a very mature young man because you are a young man. But you're very mature. You're very focused on what you want to do. And I think that's awesome. I think that's awesome. That's why I wanted to talk to you to see how you got this done so you can tell people. What would you tell somebody right now? Because like I told you that in that video, I got that email. And I've gotten emails where guys are not only have degrees, okay, they have certs, Microsoft, CompTIA, Cisco. They got certs, they got degrees, they got some experience, but they know their stuff. They know their stuff, and they can't get jobs. What would you recommend to those people to do? You know, to get to the position that you're in.
Well, some of it is luck, but a lot of it is your attitude. You know, toward putting in the resume, looking online, and don't be afraid to say, oh, that, you know what, that's kind of in my realm, but that's not as high as I expect, so I'm not going to go there. Don't do that, because I was like that initially until I changed my mind, because I was looking at these things, I'm like, wait a minute, I have my CCNA, I'm not going to go to like a... because I was looking for more like an administrator or engineer position. Then there's these other ones where it's like you're network trouble.
Yeah.
Network troubleshooting. I was like, man, that's not really. But some guys came over and they're like, hey, man, you get your foot in the door.
Exactly.
Then they'll see what you can do, right? They'll see what you can do and then you'll go up, you know it. Nothing, you can't expect to just walk in the door and be up there with, you know, everybody else that had 15, 20 years experience.
That's not going to happen. Exactly. I mean, that's what I tried to do. One of the things that I did is I couldn't get a job to save my life. I was certified, had my degree, but nobody will hire me. Maybe they didn't like the face. I mean, I don't know. But and I'm very, I guess I come off very aggressive. And that's another thing that in today's world, I guess you got to be a little bit more sensitive in the sense that, you know, don't go in there full charging because people are going to feel, oh my God, this guy's going to kill somebody someday. So what I did is I made up cards and I passed them out and I started doing free work. And then from there it became to, you know, some money. And then I just weaseled my way in till finally I got to where I'm at right now. But like you said, don't give up and don't feel scared. Right, because find a company, because that's a key point. Find a company that doesn't have a ceiling. Find a career, find a company that's going to allow you to move up that ladder and do everything that you need to do to move up the corporate ladder. And you have, you're now in a position that some people only dream about being. Not only do you have a certificate, you have your certs, you have your degree, but you work at a data center. You're working with all these different types of new technologies. I mean, the younger generation, because when I was coming around, think about it, I was with ISDN back with DOS and friggin', you know, Windows 98 and all the stuff. So worrying about all that stuff back then. Now with all the new, and believe me, I was there, the change between NT4 and 2000, which is NT5. And there was a fight and a half that 2000 was no good and NT4 this and blah, blah, blah. People are reluctant to change. And the fear factor, I had it too. Because I was like, man, I look at the prerequisites. Well, you gotta be a CCNA, you gotta be a CCNP. What I think is funny is, oh, you gotta be, what is it? We require you to be a CCNA, but we prefer a CCIE. There's a big gap in between. But like you're not scared. You went, you took the step, and now here you are. What's your next step? What's next?
Next step is learning as much Ansible and programming in Python as possible.
Okay. And where are you going to do that? You're going to do that based on e-learning platforms? Are you going to go back to college? Because I don't want to see you with a huge debt, brother. I mean, you want to keep your money. You want to keep your money. What are you going to do?
I'm in a very, very special situation. This is, for example, a dream job for me.
Okay.
Not only did I get hired as a data center engineer, I got hired for the sole purpose of automation.
Nice.
That's it.
Okay.
But when I started this job, which was about 8 months ago.
Okay.
So not that long.
Yeah, but still.
I knew this much of Python.
And now?
Well, now I'm pretty proficient at it.
There you go. So in 8 months. But so you're a smart guy. You know what I mean? You're a smart guy. You pick up things quickly. Again, you want to learn more Python. You want to be the man in Python. Nobody can tell you anything. You're going to be the expert in Python. You're going to do it where? Where are you going to go? What is your plan? Are you going to buy a library book? Are you going to go course a CD? Are you going to go to an e-learning platform? Do you have any ideas of what you're going to do? Because if you go to college, I'm not against college. I'm against paying a lot of money.
Yeah.
All right?
It's very expensive, and it seems to be getting more expensive.
Yes.
When I was back then. So here's the thing. There's lots of learning opportunities online that you can find.
There you go.
Python and Ansible.
Okay.
For example, Udemy is a great place.
Okay.
Right there, you can go pick up courses for Python engineers or Python for networking engineers.
Okay.
But the one thing is that I want to get across is Ansible. Right now, for networking equipment, is so fresh.
Okay.
People are looking for that everywhere.
They're not compatible? It's not compatible with all different platforms?
So, yes, it is. But it wasn't like that a year ago.
Oh, wow. Okay.
It's very new. Ansible was used for servers, for deploying servers, operating servers and stuff like that. Just recently, it started being used for networking
devices.
For Cisco, Juniper, Brocade, F5, anything, Aruba, Arista, everything. And it's very fresh, very new. When I came into this position, they wanted somebody with Ansible experience. And I saw all the prerequisites. You know, we want this, we want that. And at first I was like, I don't know that. I don't know Ansible, I don't know Python. But I was like, you know what, let me at least give it a shot. Maybe in the interview I could say, hey, I don't know much about that. But I'm willing to learn. I'm willing to, you know, whatever you guys require me to do, I'll try my best. And they saw that. They saw that. They're like, okay, let's hire this guy. Let's see if he can actually begin learning some Ansible and Python.
So that's the whole thing. So you went in there. You went in there with passion. You went in there with the desire to succeed. Yes. And they saw that. They say, hey, you know what? This guy may not know it now, but maybe in a month or two or three, he's going to know it. You know what I'm saying? And because he's willing to do whatever it takes to know that. And that's really the key to any job that you go to. Because I know when I went into telecommunications, I knew, you know how much telecommunications I knew? Zero. Zero. I was lucky, very lucky, that I worked with a good team. And they just got to me and they just filled my head and notes and whatever. And they trained me very well. And they told me, okay. And I got there because I had to train their engineers for CCNA. Not that they didn't know how to work routers. They just need to know, why am I typing IP helper address? They didn't know what that was. But they needed their cert regardless. All right. They needed their cert. So they taught me. They had years of experience. Good people. One of the things is that telecommunications company merged. There was one guy that stood out above the rest in that group because he said, you know what? Exactly what you said. I don't know their equipment. I don't know their software, but I'm not going to sleep, all right, until I learn all their stuff. So I think it's what you're saying. It's, you know, forget the fear. If this is what you want, if you want to live a comfortable life, at least not out there like I used to be in construction, out in the sun, you know, because like my wife told me, when I'm 60 years old, which I'm not too far away from that, when I'm 60 years old, I don't want to be shoveling dirt and doing all that stuff. It's a different lifestyle. And not only that, you get compensated a lot better, where that means not only will you have a better lifestyle, but your family as well. So, I mean, I think you're awesome, dude. You know, I'm glad that I was a little tiny bit, you know, part of your improvement, I guess, in IPs or submitting, whatever it is that I was able to help you. I appreciate your professor. Tell him thank you for pointing you to me. But definitely the technology world is changing and you got to change with it. And that's one thing that you pointed out that's very important. So in ending, what advice you have for me? Tell me, what would you like to see from me next? Okay, what would you like me to do that you think will benefit network engineers right now? What do you think I should focus on and teaching? Because I'm teaching CCNA left and right. I'm teaching it in Spanish now because people didn't know. Okay, hola, español.
Very excited for that.
You know, so I'm doing it in Spanish because there is a lot of Spanish-speaking people that are having, you know, issues with the CCNA.
Yeah.
Okay? There's a whole continent that, you know, that can't study it because nobody teaches it. So I want to be that guy. But that's CCNA. It's all fine and dandy. Things are changing. You talked about Ansible. Talked about Python. I know Meraki. I think I'm saying it correctly. Meraki servers. All right, because not even the packet tracer has Meraki. You can't do anything with it.
Yes.
Not that I know of. But because I went inside, I'm like, okay, what do you do here? What do you think? What should be something that I should put out there that will help people acquire a job? At least they can talk their way through intelligently, you know, and get their foot in the door.
Okay. Well, right now, people are looking for Ansible experience or at least some Python experience because it's very fresh, it's very new, and you can learn it quick. I only did it in a few months to get the hang of it. Now I'm pushing Playbooks where I update the OS for 200 devices.
Whoa, okay.
The config as well, you can make config changes like that. You can push a configuration change. You can pull facts. You can gather a whole Excel spreadsheet of your network. I mean, it scales incredibly well, Ansible.
Okay.
So I would say if you can learn a little bit about that and incorporate that into the course,
okay.
I use GNS3.
Perfect.
Since through GNS3, you can move in a Linux device, Ubuntu, Red Hat, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
You can download Ansible.
Okay. And, well, you know I'm in GNS3 as well, so you can You can watch me there also. But, all right, so, yeah, because GNS3 allows for a lot of platforms. Yeah. And I know GNS3 has a certification, if you didn't know, it's called GNS3A.
It recently came out,
Yep. And I'm going to go ahead and take that as well, because it teaches you Python, teaches you how to do APIs, it teaches you some Linux. There's a whole bunch of stuff in there. 90% of it is GNS3, obviously. You got to know how to use that. But you need to learn the rest of it. Okay, so GNS3 will be the way to go. All right, cool. So I can make sure in that. And I can, but the Hansible, it will be a download right from GNS3? Or do I need to go to a specific place? How costly is it? Do you know? Just quick questions or top of your head.
The best cost is for free.
Oh, really?
Hansible is open source.
Oh, it's open source.
The Hansible website right now, you can go to the website, you look up network modules, you'll get 500, 600. They're updating it every single day, adding new features to it, adding more functionality to it.
Okay.
And if you want, I can send you some examples of some playbooks that you can do.
Okay. That would be awesome.
Just like, yeah, I can show you how to set up, how to install it on your Linux box, and then just how to run basic playbooks and what you can do with them.
Oh, dude, that will be awesome. That if you can do that.
It's what I do every day, so I'm getting better at it every day.
Well, then you need to start making videos too, and you start helping people and putting your stuff on e-learning platforms. Why not? You should. If you know how to do it, then just, you know, put your stuff up there. Because, you know, this recording is going to go on YouTube.
Right.
All right? And people are not going to know you.
I want people to know that Ansible is the next step. Python is the next step. You get the CCNA, and that's good. But within 5-10 years from now, people are going to be expecting more. You know, it's not going to be no longer the CCNA. It's going to be, okay, well, you got the CCNA. What else do you have?
Exactly.
Everything's going to SDN.
Exactly.
The thing I want to specify is you don't need Python experience. You don't have to know nothing about Python. I didn't when I started with Ansible. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
I started Ansible first, not knowing anything about Python. Python, I knew it was a programming language.
Well, that was step one.
Yes, I knew it was a programming language, but I didn't know how to program in Python.
Okay.
I started Ansible using a day one book from Juniper, and those are for free. You can get them. And that day one book is, they have some stuff for Juniper, but it gives you the wider range, and it shows you all the modules where you can use it for Cisco, for Broke, I mean, whatever, Aruba, Arista, whatever you want. It gives you kind of like, hey, this is how it works for Juniper. But it also works for Cisco the exact same way.
All right.
You don't have to change nothing.
All right. So what you're saying is, to summarize this, so we don't bore our people, okay? Not that what you're saying is boring, because I'm enjoying it a lot, and we can keep talking for 3 hours, and I wouldn't mind, okay? But so you're saying, okay, get your CCNA. That's fine. Start maybe with Hansible, because it's an open source, and it's, you know, free. You can download over 500 modules. And then use GNS3, okay, where you can do all these different platforms and get some knowledge on Python, which you're saying is very simple to do, which in 8 months, you've pretty much got the hang of it, but you want to know more of it now. Okay, well, good. Then that's what's going to happen. So I'm going to hold you to it, Louis. I'm going to hold you to it. You're going to teach me now.
I'm going to send you something.
You're going to teach me now. And I'll tell the world that you taught me how to use this, okay? And who knows, man, one day you and me can collaborate and we can do a course together and we can put it out there, okay? And just get you out there, man, because regardless of the matter, if this is what networking is all about. It's not just about IP addresses or Hansible or Python or routers and switches and cabling. It's about getting together with other people like yourself who are passionate, who are dedicated and committed, and want to help other people, show them that they can do it too. And this is my goal as well, okay? Is to make sure that we can make a community of people so we can move forward. But for that to happen, luckily, people now know me, okay? But I now want people to know you. Because what you've done as young, listen, man, I'm not trying to insult you or anything, okay? You're a young guy. At 22, you should be out in some club somewhere. At least I was. in some club somewhere trying to pick up some female, you know, whatever. But here you are, dude, and you're doing this stuff. So you're preparing for your future. You're preparing for your future, and not a lot of young kids, because you got your degree, you got your certs, and a lot of kids here in, well, I'm in the UK right now, but when I say here, I'm in the US. In the US, their bachelor's is 4 years, you know? And sometimes it takes them 6 years because they're not really committed. You, my friend, are one committed, passionate individual. Regardless of what school you went to, the fact that you saw me, whatever, it doesn't matter because you did the work and you're the guy. So I'm going to hold you to it now. I'm going to be waiting for your videos. I can't wait. Okay? I'm serious. Send me something. Send me like a video, a little desktop recording. Doesn't really matter. And just tell me, hey, lads, this I do it, ABC. Remember, man, I don't got much hair. Well, I don't got no hair. So make it, you know, nice and easy for me, all right? But let's do this. Let's help each other out. Let's help the world out, okay? And to get them into this industry and help these network engineers go to the next step. Does that sound good to you?
Absolutely. Sounds great.
Okay, awesome. So we're going to end this, okay? Because we don't want to bore people. All right, so I just want to say one thing. Thank you, everyone, for attending. I always look at the wrong place. For attending this particular session of Skype. Lewis here, 22-year-old CCNA, CCNP, with his bachelor's degree. Am I correct?
Yes.
Bachelor's degree. All right. Already in his field. In his field for over 8 months now, right?
Yeah.
In the data center. And he's doing automation, something that we need to be doing as well. And now Lewis is going to show me how to, or we're both going to get together and show the world how this is really done. So you can stop saying, is this what you do in the real world? Thank you for watching.